God bless you all, everybody. I want to share something with you all. I don't normally speak unless the Spirit of God says to speak. And even when God give me a word, I prefer to accept confirmation, on top of confirmation. I was here today, people of God. Now I'm going to backtrack. I'm going to backtrack in the year 2016. Many of you all remember I came on Facebook and I told you guys that I got a vision for Jamaica. And in the vision that I got for Jamaica, that was the starting of Joshua Generation Ministries, for all who remember. That vision was also featured in the Gleaner a couple years ago. I think it's 2016 or 2016, 17, one out of the 2 years. When the Lord said unto me, people of God, that Jamaica is going to be split in two. And I didn't understand the vision those time, people of God, because you see, when God give you a vision, it don't fulfill maybe the same time. It's maybe for years on top of years. And now the Holy Spirit is showing me that the vision that I got a couple years ago, it is for now. So backtrack a little, people of God. To remind some of you who may have not known about the vision, I'll send you guys the link that I shared in the Gleaner, when it came out in the Gleaner. I'll share it with you guys so you can read it and see the date. In the vision, I stated that I saw Jamaica. I remember when I was on my bed the night, and the Spirit of God come and take me up in the air, and I saw Jamaica split into two. And when Jamaica split into two, there was nothing but fire running through the middle. And when the fire was running, there were persons that was in the center of the fire, and they were crying out for help. And in the dream, people of God, I remember when a plane come to escort some of us, and the plane came and rescued the Christians. And I told you guys that the Christians in Jamaica is going to go through a terrible warfare. It was featured in the Gleaner. Dated, I don't remember the time, but I have the link still, people. I'll be sharing the link. And I remember, people of God, so clearly people were crying out for famine. And I said that there is going to be a famine coming to Jamaica shortly. And this is nothing to take as a joke. And people of God, I shared it on Facebook, and then this lady texted me, and she said she worked with the Gleaner company, and she would like to post my vision and have an interview with me and put it in the Jamaica Gleaner. I said, okay, go ahead. And she did that, and that was my first time I was featured in the Gleaner. And from there, continual. Backtracking from then, coming now up to this time period, I was here the other day, people of God, and the Lord gave me a word. Last year, I think it was about October, and he said to me, people of God, in the vision, that I should start getting non-perishable food items. And I should take these food items and I should start to pack them away in my house, because they're going to be needed, because rainy day is coming. And people of God, I remember when I got the vision so clearly, I was so disobedient, I didn't do any of that. Because first and foremost, I start looking at it and said, the things that are non-perishable, I don't eat mackerel first and foremost. And mackerel is non-perishable. But I like sardine, and sardine is non-perishable. And those are the items, right? So anyways, I remember I was here, people of God. I shared the vision with a couple of my co-workers. I shared it with a couple of my friends. I shared it as well on Facebook. And I started, people of God, to take up the habit as of late December to start buying up tin products. Every time, people of God, every weekend, I would buy up some tin products and I pack them away in my house. When I pack them away in my house, the other day, people of God, I was here. And when I was here, people of God, I remember I said, no man, me no want them products here go spoil, and I don't want them go expire. So you know what, me give them away. So I give them away, people of God. When I give them away, I remember I was at work just last week, and the Spirit of God came down to me when I was in the bathroom doing my midday prayer, people of God. And I remember the voice said unto me, what did you just do? Didn't I told you to get some non-perishable food items and put them up? And the voice come back to me again and said, buy some non-perishable food items, pack them away in your house. This is a warning from the Lord. Trouble is upon the city. Trouble is upon the land. And people of God, I did that. I started to buy back a little things, people of God, and I stacked them up in my house. Now, I'm a person like this. Many times, the Spirit of God, when he wants to show me like a deep vision, he will say, go to your bed. I will just hear a voice say, go and go sleep. I was here, people of God, and I heard a voice said to me, go and lay down and go sleep. So I obeyed the Spirit of God, whereas I was feeling a bit tired. I went and got to sleep, people of God, and I had a vision. I'm not going to say anything right now much concerning it, but I'm going to share the few important points that I was given permission to share. In the vision, people of God, when I saw the, I had a vision going back to the time when the week here did come out. And remember the $10,000? I saw the $10,000. I saw our prime minister going overseas. I saw in the spirit a document. I saw a signing of a document. And on that document, people of God was placed using Jamaica to become a testing field. And the permission was given, people of God. And I am sorry to say this, but the brother God we want to love so much, him sell out. That man sell out. And I don't know, people of God, many people will take the little $10,000 what that man was giving you. You just sold over your own rights. That $10,000 that you get them done, pay you already for your own rights. And they're coming with the vaccine, and things are going to get a whole lot worse. I don't know about you all who is so troubled by this. When I look on the curfew order, every Sunday is a no movement day. Why is it that Sunday is the no movement day? What about Saturday? What about Friday? What about Thursday? What's about the Sunday? Because the Sunday have to be the no movement days. The Spirit of God showed me a little while, people of God, and reminded me and said, this was why I said to you to serve up some non-perishable food items. I have witness of persons that have been telling this vision over the many months that the Lord is speaking unto me. Julian Keating from Portmore is a witness. I have many more witnesses as well. I can call their name. Wayne from Portmore is another witness. Cheryl is another witness. The Lord showed me the vision and said, get some non-perishable food items because trouble has come upon the land. People of God, I just want to encourage you all, as the Spirit of God said. This was the only word God give me right now, so if it spread, the rest him said don't talk as yet, not the time as yet. But he said to tell his people to get some non-perishable food items. Stop them away in your house because famine is coming. Remember, the Lord spoke unto Joseph and he said unto Joseph, he gave the dream to Pharaoh, people of God. When Pharaoh, you know, people of God, was the famine was coming unto Egypt. The word of God declared that when Joseph interpreted Pharaoh's dream, he said unto him, there's going to be 7 years of famine and there's also going to be 7 years of prosperity. People of God, the Lord is saying unto us, stock up on some non-perishable food items. The Lord said, I have not sent Katu, Rabba, Shekosa. I have not sent any storm over Jamaica in the ears because Ekonda Kashataba Baba Shekotora Babosa Rebe Kushataya. The punishment of mankind, Ekoda Bebe Sikutu Rebosha. There is a way that seems right unto man, but the end is bitter. Trouble is coming upon the land, said the Spirit of God. People of God, get some non-perishable food item. Put them away that you may be reserved. This is a word from the Almighty God to his people.